Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the beautiful Oregon coast. It's my great honor to be the first one to welcome you to Corey and Socha's wedding reception. My name is Layla. This guy behind the decks here is my husband, Jeff. We're going to be your MCs and DJs this evening. I know a lot of you have traveled a really long way to be here, and it's not just the beach that brought you here today. But first, before we bring back our newlyweds, I want to share with you the real story of Socha and Corey. Socha was born and raised in St. Paul. Corey grew up in rural Minnesota, but it was a mutual love of beer that would bring their lives together in the fall of 2005. Her first night on the job as a beer promoter was the first night they met, but as far as first impressions go, Corey didn't exactly score a home run. Socha assumed he was cold and aloof, but sure enough, once they were a few beers deep at one of their promotions, it became clear that their shared sense of humor would form the basis for a great friendship. She was a big hit with Corey's guy friends, routinely stopping over for the latest comic book or sci-fi movie, or classics like Dumb and Dumber. It was shortly after a rough breakup for Socha in 2008 that Corey convinced her to go to a movie after one of their promotions. Ironically, the movie they chose was The Breakup, which at the time brought Socha to both laughter and tears. Soon after Memorial Day of that year, they were officially a couple. 5 years into their relationship, Corey admitted to himself that he had grown up quickly with Socha, and in his words, "I'd better do something quick before I screw this up." Their joint birthday month of November became the perfect backdrop for Corey's proposal. He decided to investigate Socha's plans to surprise him on his birthday and found out she had made reservations at a French restaurant in St. Paul. He enlisted the restaurant staff to create an intricate setup to get them posed for a picture in front of some Christmas trees. But that night, the restaurant was bustling and no one was able to help. Socha was freezing cold and getting annoyed, and Corey realized he had to let go of his perfect plan. By the time they were seated, the champagne ordered, Corey could no longer contain himself and immediately dropped one knee to pop the question. Socha's complete and utter surprise could be summed up by her first response, "Are you really doing this right now?" Well, here and now, they have publicly declared their love and commitment to one another in front of the Pacific Ocean on their closest of friends and family. So please join me in welcoming Socha and Corey.
Thank you. I just want to thank everybody for coming out. I want to thank Kyle. I think you did a great job today. And for your efforts, I grabbed you a bottle of the nectar. That was the talk of the town at Chester's. The lady goes, "Do you know what that costs?" Good luck keeping that sealed all night. Nice job, Kyle. Thank you. I'd like to thank Socha's dad. Without his help, none of this would have been possible. So, Gary, thank you so much. I'd like to thank Grandma Coco for the reception last night. There was a lot of people that helped out, but thank you for running point on that. I thought it was great. I'd like to thank the staff here, Zach. You guys did a phenomenal job setting up. So she can be demanding. I know we have a couple grandmothers here that are very, very excited to see Socha dance tonight at her wedding. Yay. I'm glad I could make that happen. But that's about all I got. So thank you everybody for coming out. Thank you for enjoying this day with us. I'm thank you to the weather for getting it together. And thank you for all the beer I'm going to drink tonight. Do you want to say anything?
Nope.
Thank you again.
You said it all. Social may be demanding, but this is a once-in-a-lifetime event. So here we are to witness their first dance as husband and wife. A truly beautiful couple and a